بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد. So today, alhamdulillah, we have a faida from the book Al-Mughni, written by Al-Muwaffaq ibn Qudāmah, rahimahullah, who passed away in the year 620 after Hijrah. The one whom Shaykh al-Islam said regarding that, "I do not know anybody who has come out of Ash-Sham more knowledgeable than Ibn Qudamah, rahimahullah." And Ibn Qudamah, rahimahullah, has many books in different sizes, in different sciences, in Aqidah, Lum'atul I'tiqad, a famous book, which isn't big, it's small, and it is studied and taught. Also, he has a book called In Usul al-Fiqh, Rawdatu al-Nadhir, a book that we study in the Islamic University of Medina for over 4 years. And in Fiqh, he has a number of books. In fact, he has a syllabus, and this syllabus, inshallah, we could maybe talk about a different time, but maybe the first book from that syllabus, which is at a beginner's level in the Hambali madhab generally, is called Umdatul Fiqh. Umdatul Fiqh, which is written by Ibn Qudamah. However, he's got this book also, which is called Al-Mughni. Now, Al-Mughni is the last book in the syllabus. Why? Because, as the ulama call it, it's in Ikhtilaf Al-Ali. Al-Ikhtilaf Al-Ali. It's in a high level of comparative fiqh, where any issue that comes by, he mentions all of the ulama, all of the opinions from the salaf, the sahaba, and so on. And it's a very, very big book. In fact, it's 15 volumes. In fact, it is 15 volumes, as you can see here. So, today we have a fa'idah from this book, Al-Mughni, which I'm going to go to now, inshallah. Now, this fa'idah is in the second volume, and in the book of Salah, because the fa'idah that we're going to talk about today is regarding Salatu al-Witr. And it's in the fasal al-Witru ghayr wajib, that the ruling of Witr is that it's not obligatory. However, it's a highly recommended sunnah that everybody should do. And he mentions that this is also the opinion. Obviously, this is a Hanbali book, so this is the opinion of the Hanbalis, and also Imam Malik, and also Imam al-Shafi'i. But then he mentions Abu Bakr radiallahu an, and also Abu Hanifa, they said that it is obligatory. So they had the opinion that it is obligatory. And in here we have another fa'idah, that a lot of people, a lot of your youngsters, they learn a small mas'ala, and they want to go and attack other people, not knowing that the depth of the mas'ala that is being talked about. So as you can see here, a lot of the time the Hanafi madhab is being attacked. And sometimes, without any doubt, they have opinions which may not necessarily be the strongest. Myself, I've written actually a 50-page refutation on the Hanafis regarding the mas'ala of Raf'ul Yadain. Okay? We brought all the hadith and refuted them. And it was one of the essays I had to write for the Islamic University of Medina whilst I was there. However, I'm not going to publish that. Why? Because I have only read a little bit compared to the ulama, okay, and it's going to have a lot of mistakes. And if I was to publish it, if somebody who was actually knowledgeable, they would come and just refute me. So the point being is, yes, sometimes their opinions might not be the strongest, but at the same time, we don't think that just because you learn a certain masala that you know it inside out, and secondly, you go out trying to refute every Tom, Dick and Harry that you see. So the Hanafi madhab is being attacked a lot of the time, but as you see in this masala, They do have actually very strong ahadith, authentic ahadith. They also have a sahabi. They have Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, the first khalifa after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the best of the sahaba, also having this opinion. Alakulihal, we're not here to talk about the fiqh mas'ala. The correct opinion, inshallah, is with the majority, which is that it is not obligatory. Okay? And he mentions, Ibn Qudamah mentions all of the proofs, and then maybe a nice way to summarize it is what Ali radiallahu anhu says regarding Salatul Witr. And Ali radiallahu anhu, he says, إِنَّ الْوِتْرَ لَيْسَ بِحَتْمٍ وَلَا كَصَلَوَاتِكُمْ الْمَكْتُوبَةِ وَلَكِنَّ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهُ وَسَلَّمَ أَوْتَرَ. That Salatul Witr is not obligatory, and it's not like the five obligatory prayers, meaning, and then he says, وَلَكِنَّ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ أَوْتَرَ. However, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam used to do witr, saying that it is very highly recommended, but it is not obligatory like the five daily prayers. And then he mentions a number of he continues his statement, and there's other proofs well, and even Qudāmah also mentions other proofs. For example, the Prophet ﷺ used to pray witr whilst on a riding beast, and we know whilst you're on a riding beast like a camel or a horse, you can only pray nawafil and you cannot pray the obligatory prayers. So that's also a proof to show that it is not obligatory. However, the point that I wanted to mention, okay, and going into the khilaf is, you know, it's a high level and it's for the lessons of fiqh. The one I wanted to mention is this here, the statement of Imam Ahmad here. So the Ibn Qudamah, he says, وَهُوَ سُنَّةٌ مُؤَكَّدَةٌ. Okay? And it is a very highly recommended sunnah mu'akkada. Okay? Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. And we mentioned this is the opinion of Imam Ahmad, Imam Malik, and Imam Shafi'i. So Imam Ahmad here, now he has a statement. And keep in mind that he says it's not obligatory. But with that, what does he say? He says, مَنْ تَرَكَ الْوِتْرَ عَمْدًا. Whoever leaves off the witr salah on purpose, intentionally, فَهُوَ رَجُلُ سُوءٍ, then he is an evil person. وَلَا يَنْبَغِي أَنْ تُقْبَلَ لَهُ شَهَادَةٌ, and it is not befitting for you to accept his witnessness, or it's not befitting for you to take him as a witness. Meaning, this is an evil person, a person who consistently leaves off the witr salah, he's an evil person, you cannot trust him. SubhanAllah. And with this, what is he saying? And here is a proof for that. The Imam Ahmad actually says, فقال الوتر ليس بمنزلة الفرض. That Imam Ahmad, he said, that witr is not at the level of being a fard, being obligatory. But with that, look what he says. من ترك الوتر عمدا فهو رجل سوء ولا ينبغي أن تقبل له شهادة. That the person who leaves off witr, then he is an evil person and you should not accept his statement as a witness. SubhanAllah. So we should really ponder over, are we from those who actually pray the witr prayers, or are we lazy when it comes to witr prayer? Because I know a lot of people become lazy with the witr. Sometimes shaitan comes to us and he says, oh, the sunnah is to pray at home, so let's not pray in the masjid, let me wait until I get home. And then when you get home, you know yourself that you become busy, you become lazy, and you forget about it and you sleep without praying. So this, inshallah, should be an encouragement for all of us to pray. So just to summarize this video again, there are three benefits. The first is regarding Ibn Qudamah and his book. The second is regarding, you know, different opinions, especially in fiqh. In aqidah is a different issue, but in fiqh, it's generally a bit more relaxed. Okay, but this is not to say that, you know, just because there's khilaf that it's okay for you to take any opinion. La. But the point I'm trying to make is having respect. And if you're, especially as a beginner, then not to get too excited in simple terms. Okay, that's why, you know, even Hilla Talib Ilm, the author, he mentions that the ilm is thalath ashbar, that knowledge is three levels. The first is that you learn a little bit and you think takabbar, you become arrogant and you think you know. That's why there's actually a very nice statement of some of the ulama where they say, "Man qalla ilmuhu kathura inkaru, wa man kathura ilmuhu qalla inkaru." That whoever has less knowledge, then his inkar, his refutations, and him telling other people off will increase. But whoever's knowledge increases, then that all of that will increase. Why? Because he will understand better. So this is the second one regarding the khilaf, etc. But the third one, the reason why I decided to make the video was regarding the statement of Imam Ahmad. And by the way, this is on the second volume of Al-Mughni, page 594. Where Imam Ahmad says, whoever leaves off the witr salah intentionally, then he is a evil person, and it is not befitting for you to accept his witness statement. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.